Samo. Takendula.
Hey, what's good, YouTube? Right here. I didn't want to do it. Didn't want to do it, but gotta talk about MGTOW here. Gotta talk about MGTOW. Have to do it. Because this is an exponential growth we're seeing. And truth be told, I've kind of been MGTOW myself without even really knowing what it was. Because I'm a Christian for one thing. So there's that. But, or Christian, I believe in God, we'll say that. And like, I am Christian, but it's not like other organized belief systems are wrong. But yeah, we'll just leave it there. I got a buddy that we're gonna discuss more of that shit later on the channel, like way later if this gets viewers, but for now let's just talk about the exponential growth of MGTOW here. This is a movement that will probably end up being mainstream at some point, even though it's being fought back by a lot. By the powers that be, we'll just say. And this is like something that's more common in the cities, but as even the suburbs and countryside start to get flooded with people, because at least that's how it's happening here in California, because I'm a country boy, but even like this place is getting flooded with a lot of people. As like more people keep coming in, we'll probably see the growth of MGTOW in those areas, because this seems more to be like a city philosophy. To be honest, just because in the city they like playing with like supply and demand there, like a little bit more than I'm used to at least. But MGTOW usually occurs after taking the proverbial red pill. I think it's fair to say that term has reached a lot. At least it's reached colloquial status, if not more than that. Like, I don't know if it's mainstream yet, but this is when you essentially realize that society is composed for women, not gonna lie. At least a lot of it is, in terms of socially, politically, and financially. And I am in California, so that probably impacts it at least probably a good amount, because we're quote-unquote, at least we vote progressive here, even though most of the state is actually red. But the cities are big enough to the point where we vote progressive. So socially, politically, and financially. And it's not even made, not even composed for women and children, it's mostly just women. Because if you're a boy, I'm pretty sure you had stories of when you were a child, when you got like neutered in a sense, not literally, but, or maybe even like literally for some people that I know, not gonna lie, but, or, well, not completely neutered, but just, you were not allowed to like do your full thing while you were going through the schooling. And then you definitely weren't taught practical life skills, let's just say that. You weren't allowed to do your own thing, you weren't taught practical life skills, and you left probably thinking most of the knowledge you got was useless, which, you know, I think eventually down the line your brain makes use of everything, but it's not as if you could have picked a lot of that stuff up on your own. You probably thought you couldn't though, and that's the thing, because you weren't old enough yet. At least that's what happened for me. And Eels, this is why we're seeing more boys turning to the internet for like a proper education. Like, go on our favorite channel for financial advice, for healthcare advice, for like almost anything like fixing shit. And even like learning what they want to learn as a career. A lot of times they're going to the internet to learn that. For example, I'm learning computer networking on the internet. Right, then I will go to school for it later, but, you know, I'm not the only one who realized, hey, there's a wealth of information on the internet that I can get for free, and I can go at my own pace. And that's just not a bad idea. Especially in a time like COVID. And now we'll kind of go talk about centralization. When things are centralized, it's more, I don't want to say a woman's world, but I'm just going to say a woman's world, because that kind of gets the point across a little bit. But when things are more centralized, it is a woman's world, just because everything flows to the lowest common denominator, pretty much. Like, if everything's centralized, like, if you go to a university to get a degree so you can get a job, like, if that's a must, or perceived to be a must, that's centralization. Cloud computing, for example, that's centralization. When people care about politics too much, that's centralization. And you'll see that it's like 150 million plus people voted in the recent election. And that's how you know people care about politics way too much right now. And that's centralization. Mainstream media, that's centralization, for example. So everything flows to the lowest common denominator. When there's more, the more centralization that there is, the more things flow to that lowest common denominator. And when things are kind of catered toward the lowest common denominator, everything is more controlled. There's no frontiers, or there's less frontiers, right? Because it's centralized, so there's less, like, the frontiers are now called the fringes. And the differences in thought and opinions are squashed if they're not aligned with the controlled narrative. I don't have to explain that. And then a lot of things revolve around sex, which is what I've noticed personally, honestly, just like growing up. I'm like almost mid-20s now, and I just noticed a lot of things revolve around sex, and I always kind of wondered, like, why is that? Doesn't seem to be. One, doesn't seem to be conducive to like proper growing up. And two, eventually, not gonna lie, that gets boring. Just cause, like, how much are you gonna do that with how many different people? But that's just me. Some people really like that. But why is that? Because sex is one of the only things that a woman can use to control a man. And that might be a controversial statement, but I'm just gonna leave that there. And I said a simp, I just wrote that down because that's just a common term going on. I honestly don't like using a lot of these phrases, even the word make out, but just it is what it is. Like, that's just the phrases people are using, and it kind of describes the general patterns of the period. So I'm just gonna use them, screw it. Like, you know, if you don't like it, write a comment or something. And what is a simp? I'm not gonna say it. You can just look that up, even though I wrote it down. But, okay, next bullet. Why is MGTOW growing now? In my opinion, it's all economics. Let's just be honest. This is just simple economics. Like, it's a response to inflation, in my opinion. You can only inflate the value of, we'll just call it cat, and what it takes to get cat for so long. And nature always has its way in the end. Like, things that are inflated, what goes up always must come down. And if you're just a dude who, like, grew up paying attention, you realize that, hey, like, all of a sudden, when you hit, like, 18, 20, just the inflation's crazy. Like, now all of a sudden you gotta do all this nonsense. And, like, all the, like, get money, get, like, inflated currency for a chance at having a family or whatever your goals were. Or, like, dating a woman where when you were, like, 14 or something, it was just, like, not like that, or even, like, when you were 12 or some shit. Like, it just wasn't that. And you can't all of a sudden just change the game in the middle. Like, that's kind of why I think MGTOW's getting huge, because, like, how you can't just all of a sudden change the game. That doesn't make sense. Like, you can change the game generation to generation, but you can't change the game in the middle of a generation. Or, like, you can't just completely, like, stratify the game in the middle of a generation, or else, like, you're just gonna see problems, because it doesn't make sense, logically. Yeah, and that's, like, when things don't make sense logically, I think that's when men start going their own way and doing their own shit. Because, like, men are kind of more logical. Yeah, so now you just work for and worry about yourself at this point until the inflation comes down. That's what kind of MGTOW seems like. People are just living for themselves in a sense, but, like, also recognizing, hey, like, there's some community problems that should be addressed. But not one man can address them. I think in, as a whole, MGTOW is kind of, like, addressing that. Yeah. That's kind of what I think is happening now. Like, by people's own actions, they're acknowledging the community problem. Because in a place like America, at least, and I'm pretty sure it's like this in other countries around the world, a lot of people have the idea that, oh, like, everyone's kind of out for themselves, like, make your own money. The community sense isn't there, like, there's an individual basis on stuff, but from that individual basis, then you worry about community issues rather than the other way around. And I'm gonna have a video about MGTOW versus communism, and I'll get into it more, but in a place, like, in the West, it's like the individual is first, and then the community rises from a bunch of individuals. It's like all these individuals have to make good decisions, or else the society won't last. And then from there, like, so you'll see, like, okay, what are these individuals doing? If they think the community is important, you'll see a lot of community stuff happening on the individual level. But if they don't think the community is important, then, like, you're gonna see a lot of stratification. And I think we're just seeing a lot of stratification, at least right now. But I think it's gonna come around a bit once men get their purchasing power back, pretty much, because, like, they don't have to support a family. And then that will allow things kind of align more. And then... Yeah, because of, like, men not supporting women or families anymore, pretty much, women have to support themselves. And let's just be honest, that I'm just gonna say this because I've, like, given it the benefit of the doubt for a while, but at this point it's just obvious that women don't produce stuff as well. Like, that's just a thing. Like, women, they don't, like, produce ideas as well. They don't produce, like, food as well. They don't produce, like, they, I mean, because they produce children better, basically, you know, like, because they can have children, men can't. But then, you know, men, they do most other shit. Like, that's kind of like what a man does. He does a bunch of shit. You know, I don't know why that's such a controversial statement, and even me, I tried to, like, deny that statement for the longest time, but then, but at this age, I'm just like, okay, a man, like, just does shit. Like, that's just what a man does. And like women follow men that do shit, so like, you know, screw it. I'm just gonna say it because I don't know if that's controversial or not, but I just said it. But because like women are basically attempting to produce shit, they're like not doing it that good. So like the currency gets devalued and inflated pretty much because now we need more currency to incentivize production, which doesn't make sense because, right, like logically, because a bunch of men are like not doing shit, whereas those men would be doing shit. So that's just like, that's just the logic, that's just what it is. Like, so now you have to print more currency. And I'm shocked that people don't realize this. Or maybe they do, but, you know, they're just capitalizing off of it, I don't know. Or maybe it's being realized slowly, I have no freaking idea, but it just seems obvious to me. But like, more teenagers and young adults grow up like me, pretty much. Like, grow up and see this, and then they're like, okay, whoa. Like, what is up with this inflation? And even if you don't know financial terminology, you know, everybody knows economics. Like, let's just, economics doesn't even have to do with finances specifically. It's just economics. It's just, what is it? Unlimited demand and like limited supply, or like people want, everybody wants shit, but nobody has the energy or like mass or like matter behind them to like get everything. So you have to divvy up your energy, divvy up like what you do. Like, I mean, even me, all this computer shit I'm learning, I have to like stick to certain things, even though it's like all pretty interesting. Like, I have a lot of energy and I don't have the energy to like do all of it, right? So, but I mean, it's just economics. Like, more teens grow up and young adults are just like, okay, well, the economics don't work here. And then they go MGTOW. And yeah, okay, I'm almost done. Hopefully this is under 15 minutes, but blockchains and decentralized computing, because like, I'm a nerd, so I'm gonna talk about the computing aspect, at least throw that in there. Blockchains and decentralized computing will come along with this wave of MGTOW. People will educate themselves and not trust the government as much as they used to, especially with their money. And blockchains, you're already seeing that shit come into play. Like, how many people are owning, like, buying up Satoshis and Ether right now? You know, and I'm on, like, that Filecoin shit now because if, like, people really want to get on this shit, I'm gonna try to get on that storage shit. But, yeah, decentralized computing, we all have computers, like, at relatively low costs. Yep, decentralized computing, I think, is going to be a thing. And it's going to be off of cloud computing, too. But I have videos about that in the past, and I'll have more in the future. But this is mostly about MGTOW, so I'll just leave that to the future. But alright, I'm going to see how long this video is. Hopefully it's not forever. Take care, stay healthy is the main thing, and I'll catch y'all in the next one.